Good morning, children. Welcome back to our science class. Yesterday we have learned about the convection process, that is transfer of heat in water. So today we are going to understand how the heat transfer takes place in the air. So two hands, one above the candle, one to the sides of the candle. Do you feel same temperature of heat touching your both hands equally? No. Surely the hand which is on the top of the candle feels a bit hotter when compared to the hand to the side, because here convection process takes place. Convection process takes place due to the process of convection, the heat transfers to the first hand is a bit more when compared to the hand which is to the sides. So because here there is no convection and here there is a convection of heat. So here the air moves up. Air from here moves up and touches the hand. So here the hand feels a bit hotter and here there is no movement of the air to the sides of the candle. There is no convection process. There is no movement of air. So the hand which is kept to the side is not hot, but which is kept above the candle feels a bit hotter. Have you ever observed the people living on the coastal areas? Coastal regions. See, in coastal regions, during the daytime, see this is the day, this is the night. Daytime, the land gets heated fast. When compared to the night, it also gets heated fast, but slowly. Here, fastly. So, in coastal regions, during the daytime, the land gets heated fast when compared to the night time, and when compared to the water, also land only gets heated fast. So, this is the land, this is the water, and the time is what matter? Time is the daytime. So during the daytime, in the coastal regions, land gets heated fast when compared to the water. So when land gets heated, the air present by the water comes to the land to take its place, balances, and from the warmer air from the land moves to the water to complete the cycle. Exactly opposite happens during the night time. Night time. What happens in the night time? The land becomes cooler slowly. The land cools fastly. Land cools fastly than compared to water. Land heats up fast. Land only cools down fast. So here also the movement of air takes place here, like this, goes to the water, comes back to the land. So vice versa, in coastal regions during the daytime the land gets heated fast. The air present on the sea comes to the land and from land to the water. Exactly at the night time the land cools down faster when compared to water. So the air from the land moves to the water. Air from the land moves to the water and from the water it moves to the land. So during the daytime the process of movement of air from the water to land and land to water is called as sea breeze. Sea breeze. Sorry, this is land breeze. This is sea breeze only. Because from the water the breeze is moving towards the land, so it is sea breeze. is called land breeze. So in coastal regions, during the daytime land gets heated fast. During the nighttime, land only gets cooler fast. Both the day and nights, land only heats up fast, land only cools down fast. And the air from the sea to land and land to sea is having a cycle for its rotation. And so during the daytime it is called sea breeze and during the night time it is called land breeze. And we all get sunlight from the sun and it reaches for our body or to the earth, living on earth. All living things on earth. So it is called as radiation. Is it called radiation? Heat from the sun reaches to the earth through the process called radiation. So this is about the heat transfer. How the heat transfers from one place to the other place and how it makes the equilibrium or makes the things stable. This is about the temperature when seen in the coastal regions. So that's why the windows in the coastal regions are faced towards the sea to have the cool breeze towards their houses. They build their houses in such a way that the windows in that house face towards the sea. They face towards the sea. And tomorrow we will continue with the next topic. That's all for the day. Thank you.